ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, prepare yourselves as we delve deep into Tejano music, its history, its future. You will hear the oldies but goodies, the newies but gooies, and everything in between. My name is Rick Garcia, and I will be your host on this 60-minute musical journey. So let's hear all the great songs by the great artists who made them famous, and a little bit of history behind each song. After all, I was there. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Rick Garcia, and yes, I was there. I was everywhere. It seems like I have been up and down the highways and the byways of Tejano and Conjunto music most of my life, and I've loved every single minute of it. Welcome to this edition of the Rick Garcia Hour, right here on MCR Radio. We're going to have a good time. As a matter of fact, I think I'm going to change the name of the show to the Rick Garcia Good Time Hour. It's always a good time when you talk about Tejano and Conjunto music, and of course, a couple of other genres stuck in there in between. Music is the universal language, and we are a universal people, and that's why this show and MCR Radio is so important. Why don't we start the show with Los Cucuyes and Rodney Rodriguez, their second CHR album. Boy, these guys are fast. They go in the studio, 4 or 5 hours later, they are done with the entire album. Takes me longer to set up the microphones than it does for them to record. But it just means that they are consummate professionals. They've been doing this for a long time. And their products come out really, really good. This song is from the album Si No Me Quieres. And it's a song that I originally recorded way back in the early 70s with Los Hermanos de la Rosa, produced by the legendary Tony de la Rosa on his De La Rosa label. The song was called Tu Amor. And if anybody goes back that far, you can remember Adán and Alfredo de la Rosa with their really tight brother harmonies. I mean, it was genetically linked and it sounded great. And such is the case with Rodney Rodriguez and his band as well. So what do you say we check out that latest single from his CHR album, Si Tu No Me Quieres? This song is called Tu Amor.
Tener un amor, sentir
Wow, Conjunto at its best, Los Cucuyes de Rodney Rodriguez. That song was called Tu Amor from the CHR album Si No Me Quieres. That song, that album, in fact, all the great albums of CHR Records are available on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, Spotify, Rhapsody, you name it, it's there. It's a great big giant digital universe. And I am proud to say CHR is certainly a major player in that musical universe. Hey, and speaking of major players, congratulations to MCR Radio. They are now on Amazon Fire Stick TV. So a big congratulations to Juan Mendoza, Lila Lisa, and all the great staff of MCR Radio. Onward and upward. Speaking of onward and upward, let's continue with the great musical artists of CHR Records, Mas Conjunto. Actually, I'm getting a name that I'm not unhappy with compared to some of the names that I'm generally called. Some way, somehow, I have been tagged Mr. Conjunto. Why not? I love Conjunto. So you've got me, Rick Garcia, Mr. Conjunto, right here on the Rick Garcia Good Time Hour, Mas Chingon Radio. Up next, it's a group called Los Marceles. These guys tore it up at the recent Tejano Music Awards fanfare and also at the Cadillac Bar there in downtown San Antonio. Nothing but festivities that weekend. It was nonstop. So if anybody says Tejano music is not what it used to be, Tejano music is dying, Tejano music is dead, they don't know what they're talking about. That Tejano Music Award fanfare was filled with so many Tejano and Conjunto fans, and I heard such great music of a lot of genres, surrounded by the great influences of Tejano and Conjunto music. So as I said, up next, it's Los Marceles. This song is from their CHR album, Cinco Años, 20 Días. It's a song that Marcial Chapa, leader of Los Marceles, wrote himself. It's called La Lluvia. Check it out.
Está cayendo, el cielo está nublado, y tú en mi pensamiento, ¿qué será de mí? ¿Por qué si no me quieres? ¿Por qué si me abandonas? ¿Por qué si me desprecias? Pienso tanto en ti. Me siento atrapado, destrozado por dentro. No sé si voy o vengo, ¿qué será de mí? Me dicen mis amigos que eres la mala suerte, que deje de quererte, que ya no piense en ti. Pero a Dios yo no lo culpo, tampoco maldigo mi suerte. Mejor un trago de tequila, un trago de vino y otro de mezcal. Siento atrapado, destrozado por dentro. No sé si voy o vengo, ¿qué será de mí? Me dicen mis amigos que eres la mala suerte, que deje de quererte, que ya no piense en ti. Pero a Dios yo no lo culpo, tampoco maldigo mi suerte. Mejor un trago de tequila, un trago de vino y otro de mezcal. ¡Wow!
phone with Marcial Trapa just the other day, the lead singer from that group, Los Marcelles. They are choosing songs to come in and do their second CHR album. So as I'm recording this, as I said earlier, it's the early months of 2019. So we can certainly count on at least one more Los Marcelles album on CHR Records this year. And hopefully many more for many years to come. You know, one thing I've always enjoyed doing, and I had the privilege to do this during my 40-year tenure at Hacienda Records, and that is when the second and third generation of conjuntos or Tejano music players come in. Such is the case with this next artist. Her father, well, what can I say? He's a legend. His name personifies conjunto music. I'm talking about the late, great Rubén Vela. Who can forget La Papaya? Who can forget Coco Rayado? So many other hit songs. Well, his daughter, Marlisa Vela, carries every bit of the same musical genetics. And she currently is tearing it up right now up and down the highways of conjunto and Tejano music herself. Her latest album, Aquí Estoy, on CHR Records, received great reviews and drew a lot of people to her CD release party in Harlingen, Texas, not too long ago. In fact, by performing at that CD release party, she got bookings for several other shows, including an opportunity to open for Bobby Pulido in the same city of Harlingen. That was a great performance right there. Two second-generation performers, one big night. Well, I'm proud to say that we've got Marlisa Vela on CHR Records. And what a great album this is. About half the songs in this album were written by Marlisa herself. And she puts her heart and her soul in everything that she does. She is able to do so many different styles and different genres, including some disco and some rock and some country and some mariachi and some ranchera and some conjunto. But what we're going to do right now is hear an original song that Marlisa wrote. It's right in the Tejano vein, and she does that so well. Let's check it out. It's called Olvídalo. From her album, Aquí Estoy, here's Marlisa Vela.
No sé por qué no dejo de pensar. En mi mente solo existen los momentos y sé que ya no estás. Hoy no sé por qué no te puedo olvidar. Tengo ganas de llorar otra vez. No quiero sufrir más. Desde que te perdí, solo pienso en ti. Solo siento soledad. No sé por qué no haces nada por salvar nuestro amor. Olvídalo, yo sé que
original song composed and performed by Marlisa Vela, the daughter of the late great Rubén Vela, second generation performer Marlisa. That was called Olvídalo. You know, I get asked a lot now that I've started up CHR Records, and we are almost, well, no, actually, that's not right. We are actually 1 year old. So I guess you could say we are still in our infancy, but certainly the staff of CHR Records and its management are no strangers to the music industry. I get asked a lot, what does CHR Records stand for? And a friend of mine called me up and she said, let me guess, it stands for Conjunto Hit Records. I laughed and I said, no, but that's part of it. So here I go, the official explanation of what does CHR Records stand for? Well, okay, let's start with the C. The CEO of CHR Records is a man by the name of Charles Hearn. My wife Hilda and I met him a couple of years ago. He lives in the Rio Grande Valley, but he has a history in the music business with accolades a mile long. Very skilled in the jazz and in the soul genre. Neo-soul also is what he likes to call it. And he and my wife and I got together and we just decided, well, we've all got a lot of history in the business. So let's put our skills together and we're going to start a record label that services not only Tejano, not only Conjunto, but we're going to branch out and do some rock and some soul and some country and some gospel. And you name it, we're going to do it. Now, I make no bones about it. My heart and my soul is in Tejano and Conjunto. But I've been involved in so many genres over the past 5 decades that there is no doubt that I love all kinds of music, and I'm influenced by all kinds of music. So upon the formation of CHR Records, C being Charles, being CEO, the first album released on our new label was his album entitled Winds of Change. And while it did not get much attention in the Latino world, it did very well in the jazz, soul, and neo-soul genres. So let's take a song from that album and check it out right now. Drifting a little bit away from the Tejano and the Conjunto highways, we're going to go to Charles Hearn, the CEO of CHR Records, and a song that he performed on his album, Winds of Change. This one is called Ain't No Sunshine. You got to remember this one.
Sunshine when she's gone. There's only darkness with every day. We're no sunshine when she's gone. She's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away, wonder this time where she's gone. She's gonna stay. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. This house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away. Time. all this time where she's gone. Wonder if she's gonna stay. Time she goes away. When a time she goes away. When a time she goes away. When a time she goes away.
Mr. Charles Hearn from his CHR album, Winds of Change. That was called Ain't No Sunshine. That is the C on CHR Records. Charles Hearn. Now, we've talked about that. Let's go to the H. CHR Records. We are 1 year old, but as I said, the three entities, which is Charles, myself, and this next artist, whom I'm very close to. In fact, you could say we sleep together every night. She's my lovely wife, Hilda, my other half, my better half, my best friend, my soulmate, and my business partner. She is the official H on CHR. Now, Hilda, if you followed her career at all, she does a lot of Motown, a lot of soul, a lot of blues. In fact, she and Charles Hearn have toured extensively together throughout Texas and out of state as well. Charles Hearn and myself co-produced this next song from Hilda Lamas. It's her latest single on CHR Records as we complete her upcoming album. But you know how it is sometimes. When you're at the forefront, when you're part of the management, you just gotta make sure that your artists are taken care of, even if you gotta take a back seat. And Hilda has taken a back seat while we get some of the other artists off the ground, like Los Cucuyes, Marcelas, Veronique, Medrano, Ruben Garza, Los Cucuyes. And Hilda has been working behind the scenes, doing a heck of a job as branding officer for CHR Records. But let's not forget, she's also a recording artist in her own right. So here is her latest single, produced by Charles Hearn and myself. It's a bilingual song entitled Fallen. Check it out. the lovely and talented Hilda Lamas, Fallen. I Have Fallen For You. Her latest single on CHR Records, again available wherever music is sold on all the digital platforms. So we have the C, which is Charles, the H, which is Hilda, of CHR Records. And guess what the R is for? You got it. It's Rick. CHR. Charles Hilda Rick. It's just got a better ring that way than RCH, HCR. So we decided on CHR. Now, I don't have anything to play for you from my recording years because that was way, 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 way back when I was a youngster in my teenage years, recording over at Studio B for the Freddie record label. And it was there that Mr. Freddie Martinez took me under his wings and let me become an apprentice rookie engineer there at Freddie Records. And of course, I make no bones about it that I was the guy that kind of did everything. I would take the car to get it washed. I would clean out the closets. I would engineer at nights when the real engineer would get tired, want to take a break. And luckily for me, the late, great Tony De La Rosa would like to record at night. Now, he had De La Rosa Records. So I would spend a good portion of the day at Studio B working for Freddie Records, doing all sorts of tasks that the rookie gets to do. And then when Tony would come in at night, I'd get to sit in and assist him in his recording sessions. Now, Tony was the guy that really taught me how, not just the engineering, but the producing of it. I mean, he had a great relationship with all of his artists. And at that time, he had himself, he had Los Hermanos de la Rosa, he had Bernardo y sus Compadres, he had Angel Flores, different groups all recording on the De La Rosa label. So I got a chance, and we're talking like early 70s, way before there was a Hacienda Records. So I got a chance to just really get to know all these great artists, as well as the Freddie artists. And man, I feel like I've just had a great love affair with this industry for 5 decades. And that's why I'm so glad I get a chance to get on the radio and tell my stories, because it's like I've lived in a candy store all my life. So when we started CHR Records a year ago, it kind of rekindled that old flame and the old ganas of doing something again, just totally fresh and brand new. Had a chance to do that in 1979 with Hacienda Records. And of course, I've had a chance to do all sorts of independent projects for other great labels. But CHR, other than Charles having a neo-soul and soul release, our first Latino release was a woman by the name of Veronique Medrano. So that is and always will be a very special album to me. It was released in March of 2018. So as I'm taping this show, it is roughly a year later. But that is still and always will be a special album to me. So why don't we check out a song from the Veronique Medrano CD entitled Loteria. It's got some great songs on it. And again, it's available on iTunes, Amazon. Also, don't forget the physical album is available wherever music is sold. So you can pick up your physical album. And that's what I like. I like to pick up an album in my hands or a CD in my hands. Album, I'm talking like the old days. A CD in my hands and get a chance to look at it, read all the credits and just kind of, you know, I feel like it's mine. But a lot of people are buying online now. It gets downloaded right to their computers. And who am I to argue with technology? So you can get it either way. Bottom line is, pick up a copy of anything CHR Records. It is carefully and lovingly produced, including this next song by Veronique Medrano from the very first Latin release of CHR Records. The album is entitled Loteria, and I'm very partial to this song because it's got a great meaning, and Veronique really felt it as she sang it. She teared up and choked up a little bit during the recording of her lyric, but that reminded me so much of the late, great Tony De La Rosa, because he felt his music so strong as well that he would often tear up and choke up. I've seen that happen with Bonnie Mauricio as well. So a great artist feels their music to such a degree that they become a part of it. Such is the case with Veronique Medrano. This song is called El Problema.
El problema no es que mientas, creo. El problema no es que juegues, el problema es que es conmigo. Si me gustaste por ser libre, ¿quién soy yo para cambiarte? Si me quedé queriendo sola, ¿cómo hacer para obligarte? El problema no es quererte, es que tú no sientas lo mismo. ¿Y cómo deshacerme de ti si no te tengo? ¿Cómo alejarme de ti si estás tan lejos? El problema no es cambiarte, el problema es que no quiero.
Miss Veronique Medrano, la canción se llama El Problema, from the CD Lotería on CHR Records. As I said, CHR Records is like 1 year old. We are still in our infancy. But I am so proud to say that we've attracted so many great talents. And the catalog and the artists on CHR Records is growing by leaps and bounds. And it is such an honor for me to reunite with a lot of these artists that I've not seen in a long time. Such is the fact with this next artist. I have known him for forever, and I produced a number of his albums for many different labels. You might not know the name, but you certainly will recognize the voice. The man's name is Rubén Garza. He is a legend in the conjunto world. Lead singer for Los Dos Gilbertos for many, many years. Lead singer for Rubén Vela for many years as well. I met him in 1979 when Los Dos Gilbertos signed up with Hacienda Records. And since then, I've recorded Rubén Garza, whether it was with Los Dos Gilbertos or Rubén Vela or on his own, which at one time he called La Nueva Era. And a funny thing, when I moved from Corpus Christi to set up shop of CHR Records in Harlingen, Texas, to my surprise, Rubén Garza has a hairstyling shop just down the street from the CHR offices. Now, I would like to say that I went in there to get a haircut, but anybody who's ever seen my picture knows that I don't need haircuts. I maybe get like one every other year, porque soy pelón, but that's another story. In any case, I did go see Rubén Garza, and we got to talking about the old times, the good times, and he decided to come on board with CHR Records. He partnered up with an old buddy of his by the name of Hector González, and we went in the studio, and they did an outstanding job. So in marketing this album, Rubén Garza, Hector González, they both have the last name that starts in G, González, Garza. Rubén said, you know, instead of saying Rubén Garza and Hector González, just say two G's. Now, I know that Los Dos Gilbertos were sometimes referred to as two G's, This is not meant in any way to discredit that wonderful heritage of Los Dos Gilbertos. We call Ruben Garza and Hector Gonzalez Los Dos G's strictly for and only because both their last names begin with G. And it's easier to say Los Dos G's than Ruben Garza and Hector Gonzalez. But either way, you can say it any way you want to, but what you've got to say is it is dynamite music. Ruben and Hector recorded together before, kind of went their separate ways for a while. Then they got together again, so we decided to call this album Juntos Otra Vez. Ruben Garza, Hector Gonzalez, Los Dos G's. This is the latest single from the Juntos Otra Vez album. It is entitled Esa Tristeza Mía. Check it out. CHR Records, Los Dos G's. That was Los Dos G's. Esa Tristeza Mía, from the CHR album Juntos Otra Vez. You're listening to the Rick Garcia Good Time Hour with yours truly, Mr. Conjunto Rick Garcia. I'm just going to go with it. I like it. It's got a good ring to it. Mr. Conjunto Rick Garcia. Now, I will play some things other than Conjunto on the show because I've been around so much music and so many different genres of music, it's hard to be one of anything. But Conjunto certainly is a very big part of my life and a very big part of CHR Records. Another group I had the opportunity to work with way back in the 80s. My gracious. It's hard to believe I go back that far, but yes, way back in the 80s. They were originally on Hacienda Records, then later they went on to RCA International, and I lost track of some. I'm sad to say that some have passed away. They are now playing Conjunto in the great big Conjunto genre in the sky, but the remaining group has gotten together again, led by a man named George Banda. This group is called Los Tremendos de George y Oscar. And Oscar happens to be a man named Oscar Hernandez, who is an excellent songwriter. Wrote a lot of great songs over the years, including this next song we're about to hear. This is the single from their upcoming album, Los Tremendos de George y Oscar. It's called El Caballo Colorado. Check it out.
El caballo colorado es mío. Y lo traje aquí para jugar. Dos carreras son muy importantes. Va a correrle al moro y al alazán.
Es más fuerte y más veloz que
conjunto with Los Tremendos de Georgie Oscar. That was called El Caballo Colorado, the single from the soon-to-be-released album of the same name on CHR Records. Now, I'm proud to say that CHR Records has Hall of Famers in its roster of talent. Ruben Garza, a Hall of Famer in the South Texas Conjunto Association Museum, the Tejano Roots organization. And we have a female Hall of Famer as well. Martina y Conjunto La Suerte. Martina Garcia and I go back, no relation by the way, but we go back to the early 90s when she started recording with Hacienda Records. This is another one that I lost track of when I started CHR Records, but it felt so good to receive a call from her and talk about recording with the brand new CHR record label. My answer to her was, yes, how quickly can we get started? Her answer was, right away. So we did. This is the single from her upcoming album. It's a song that Martina wrote herself. It's called Dime Que Fui Yo. Martina y Conjunto La Suerte.
Cuando te puso en mi camino, llegué a quererte mucho, queriendo estar no más contigo. Tontamente de alegría, mi corazón cantaba cada vez que te miraba.
Suerte from her upcoming CHR album, Dime Que Fui Yo. That was a title cut and the current single from that album. Again, you can find it anywhere where music is sold, including all the online platforms such as iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, Spotify, Rhapsody. There are so many out there, more being added all the time, and I'm proud to say that CHR Records has a strong presence in every single one of those digital outlets. Now, we spoke earlier about CHR and who we are, what we represent. Charles Hearn, the CEO, Hilda Lamas, the branding officer, and myself, Rick Garcia, the president. And it's cool that I get to be president because sometimes I get to act like a big shot, and sometimes I get to take out the trash, and sometimes I get to do all the menial things that come along with any kind of a business. But the main thing that I get to do and that I love, and that is produce records, produce artists, record albums. And as I mentioned as well, CHR Records represents many genres of music. Played you a little bit of neo-soul from Charles Hearn earlier. We have got some great things coming up in the field of contemporary Christian and several other genres of music. I'm also proud to say that we have a country album on CHR Records that I think is as good as anything to ever come out of Nashville or LA or you name it. I think it matches or exceeds that caliber. The artist's name is B.B. Watson. The song is called Buried Treasure. It's on CHR Records. Let's check it out right now. Buried Treasure.
As I'm walking behind this cloud, I keep turning over memories, buried treasure of a past once filled with you. This old ground, I know it's mine, and I've worked it so many times, and the rain it's been praying for is falling from my eyes, waiting for the setting sun. When a hard day's work was done, we sit down and lock the baby and plan our dreams. But you turned it all around with this other man you found, and you never thought I'd figure out your scheme. There's buried treasure hidden in the ground, precious memory of a love that lived and died. You couldn't be the simple wife, you had to leave the cheap life, and you laid me down. Now the neighbors, they all knew, they had seen him leave with you, but what they didn't see was I followed close behind. And the next day's paper read that a man had been found dead, the lady he'd been seen with, they can't find. And the buried treasure hidden in the ground, precious memories of a love that lived and died. You wouldn't be the simple.
Recording artist B.B. Watson. That was called Buried Treasure. Boy, what a segue from Mr. Conjunto Rick Garcia, right? Well, as I said before, it's hard to be in this business for 5 decades and not be exposed to many different kinds of music. I love them all, I produced them all, and I'm proud to be a part of it. Boy, you know, time sure slips away when you're having fun. I have had a blast during this hour of the Rick Garcia Good Time Hour on MCR Radio. I am your host, Mr. Conjunto Rick Garcia. So let's say goodbye. I don't want to, but we probably ought to. I don't want to hog a whole day. But until next time, we'll say goodbye with another CHR recording artist. This group is called Los Tremendos Alacranes. David Flores, he happens to be the nephew of the late, great Angel Flores. a guy that I worked with way back in the 70s, Ángel Flores, may he rest in peace, along with all the other Conjunto greats. But his nephew carries on the tradition. It's on CHR Records. The song is called El Fiti Fiti. Adios, until next time. Garcia Hour on Mas Chingon Radio, MCR. Join us every week at the same time for another edition as we stroll up and down five decades of memories and making new ones at the same time. My name is Rick Garcia. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time.